During cell division, human cells must copy 6 billion base pairs of DNA. Given enough time, mistakes are inevitable. In order to keep the situation under control, mutated cells have a function to kill themselves. However, this function too can fail, creating a cancer cell. If we think of cancer as a negative outcome lottery, large animals should be more predisposed to cancer than small animals. They have more lottery tickets due to a larger number of cells and more rounds of lottery due to a longer lifespan. However, we observe similar cancer rates across all animals.
This is Peto's paradox. While it still baffles scientists, there are a few proposed solutions. Evolution. A species with high cancer risk evolves to obtain tumor suppression genes or faces extinction. Some elephants contain 20 copies of TP53, a tumor suppression gene, while humans only contain one.
Hypertumors.
When cancer cells divide, there is a possibility of even further mutation. If one of the mutated cancer cells stops cooperating and makes copies of itself, a hypertumor is formed that unintentionally works alongside the body to defeat the original tumor. So maybe the solution to cancer is cancer. Scientists have already successfully supplied mice with tumor suppression genes. A similar treatment for humans is well within the scope of possibility. Maybe more research into the genomics and cell biology of different organisms can even lead to a cure for cancer in humans. I'm Amei, and this is Peto's Paradox Explained.